All right, folks, welcome in here to this video. Me and Brandon are out here today. It's mid-April, and we're out here fishing this small stream today. We're after native brookies, and there's also some browns in here, and this is a stream I like to fish in the past. For me, this is actually my first time here this season. I think Brandon's been here a couple times, and he's done pretty well. Water's in good condition. We weren't sure what it was gonna be like. We had some rain last night, so we weren't sure if it was gonna be too high to fish today, but it's looking really good. Just a slight bit off color, which actually can sometimes be a good thing when you're fishing for these things, because these native brookies, when they see you, it's pretty much game over. You gotta be stealthy, you gotta sneak up on them, and you gotta be accurate with your casting. Small stream like this, we're running just short rods. You can see out here, we have some pretty nice water out here in front of us. So this is the first pool we're gonna fish. What we've done is parked our trucks about at the midway point of the stretch of water that we wanna fish, and then we've walked the whole way down as low as we wanna go, and we're gonna fish the whole way up, way past our trucks. And that should work out pretty good. We got a few hours here to fish, so we're just gonna rotate on and off filming each other. And I'm gonna start off here in this first hole by just throwing a pink squirmy worm. These native trout are pretty aggressive feeders. You know, we think as long as you give them a natural presentation with anything and they don't see you when you're walking up to the hole, you should be in good shape. So we're gonna throw this in here and get to fishing today and see what we can catch. There we go.
Nice old fish.
Well, it took us long enough.
Yeah, pink lively legs, right there.
There we go, pink lively legs.
He crushed it.
Let's take a look at him.
Not big fish, but man, they don't get more colorful than that, right there. Beautiful.
Beautiful native brookie.
Yep. We'll get them back.
Plenty more of them in here.
Oh yeah, that's what we came here for. That's awesome.
First one.
A little bit of tough fishing so far. They've kind of eluded us, but we're finally getting into some better water here, deeper holes. And I think years past, we've caught more fish in this section than we have down through. So we keep fishing up and hopefully catch some more.
All right, we got limited time here to fish today. So we decided not catching much here at this stream. We caught that one, but pretty slow for the most part. So we're gonna hop in the trucks, do a location change, see if it's any better over at the other stream.
Yep. First cast at the new spot, baby.
You gotta be kidding me.
Nice.
Beautiful little native brookie. Beautiful pull out here in front of us. That's your typical average size right there.
That is beautiful.
Beautiful looking fish. We're gonna get him back. Pretty awesome right there. We were at that last stream. We fished that pretty hard. I mean, we were throwing all kinds of nymphs in there and everything, squirmy worms, and we only caught one fish. And we're like, well, what the world's going on? And we only have like another hour. So we're like, well, if we're gonna move, we gotta move now. Had this other stream in mind that wasn't too far away, and I'm glad we came over here. First cast into this pool, first spot we stopped at, even walked up the trail to get here, past the trucks, first cast in, that thing nailed it. So I think we made the right decision to move here.
Yes,
so
we did.
We're gonna keep moving upstream here and hopefully get in a bunch more of them. I saw him.
Look how tight that hole is.
He was in there.
Right above this big rock?
Right here.
Look at that.
Oh, there.
Not very big, but man, he's pretty.
Popped him right up out of the hole.
Yep. But the hand first. Oh, he was that small, went right through the net.
He went right through the net.
Hey, that's all right. That's all right.
All right, so we remember this hole from the past, the last time we were here. That undercut under that rock, we're pretty sure that's gonna be good. So we're gonna throw in there.
Fish bottom.
Come on out.
Fish.
Fish.
He's really orange.
Yeah, he is. A little bit of a slimmer, longer, slimmer one, but pretty awesome. It's unbelievable what that switch to this stream did. I mean, completely different. I mean, those fish last stream, those things wouldn't hit anything. We know they're in there. They just didn't want to feed, or I don't know if they're getting a lot of pressure or what. And now this stream, it's like they're just hitting everything they see.
Oh my word.
And then I got them on the fly.
Oh, you came off.
Did you see that?
That was incredible. He hit the strike indicator and then you hooked him.
He took the strike indicator and I hooked him on the fly.
That was pretty wild.
That was insane.
Well, that's when you know you're fishing for aggressive fish.
Oh yeah. These fish are aggressive today.
Oh, that was better again.
Fish. That was a good fish.
Got him. Another fish.
Another one. Little guy.
There we go.
There's some bigger ones in there, but got the small one. Pink lobby legs, man, killing it today. There he is. Another pretty one.
Beautiful.
Off he goes. This is awesome.
I mean, I don't even remember now how many fish we've hooked.
I think it's at least 7.
It's every other cast almost.
Yeah. And there's 2 more in there.
Yep.
And they were bigger ones.
Oh, I don't know if that was bottom.
I don't know. Didn't see. That's a fish.
I think he's gonna fall through the net too. Pretty bright orange on the bottom of that guy.
Yeah.
Put him back where we caught him.
Yep. There's more in there.
You would think, like, if there's going to be a big one in here, that's a good spot for a big one to lay.
Oh, yeah. Right under that undercut rock?
Yeah.
No doubt. Let's do it again.
Oh, that was a good fish. Hey.
I think it was.
Lost.
And they're just pounding that thing.
Oh my word.
There's probably a whole pile laying in there.
Oh yeah. Yep.
Oh yeah.
Right where we thought he'd be.
Came off right
lost.
Before the net.
Ooh.
That one looked pretty good looking.
Well, a few minutes ago, actually a few fish ago, I hooked that fish and it hit my strike indicator, so that intrigued us. So we caught a few more fish, and now I'm tying on an elk hair caddis because we're going to try to catch the first fish of the season on a dry fly.
Right there it is. There we go.
And we got a nice hole up here.
Perfect spot for a dry.
Oh yeah. A little waterfall coming in, some slow water. Perfect.
Right up in there.
Let's do it.
All right, we got the caddis on.
Yep.
Here we go.
Ready?
Yep.
Did you see it?
Oh, I saw it.
Did you see it?
Right away, as soon as it hit the water.
As soon as it hit the water, come on.
You see it?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah, first fish of the season, baby, on a dry fly. Woo!
It's gonna go right through my net.
Look at that, elk hair caddis right in the upper lip. That is awesome. And we're sending them back. Oh yeah.
Not big, but it was on the surface.
That's what we love.
I wasn't filming, but Brandon hooked one out of that pocket in there.
Good.
Yep.
Get him back.
Got him.
Oh yeah. Pink lobster legs, man. Killer.
They're just crushing that thing today.
Oh my word.
Yeah. Okay. Oh yeah.
That's awesome. This is so much fun. Fish aren't huge, but man, you just look around at all this beautiful scenery. Trout don't live in dull places, I'll tell you that right now. Oh, we're just walking back to the truck and we're trying to catch fish and I just caught
them. Well, I guess we might have to end the day on that.
One last ditch effort. Great day on the water. We'll be back at it next time. We'll be right back.